Hi, I'm Steve Posnack, Director of ONC's Federal Policy Division. It's my pleasure to welcome you to our first Meaningful Use Personal Pace Education module. This education module will cover transitions of care from both a Meaningful Use and EHR Technology Certification perspective. Over the next 16 minutes, I'll be using these slides to walk you through the requirements for the Meaningful Use Transitions of Care objective and measures, as well as their relationship to EHR Technology Certification. This education module assumes you have general familiarity with the Medicare and Medicaid EHR incentive programs, quote-unquote meaningful use, the Standards and Certification Criteria 2014 Edition Final Rule and Standards Terminology, and the relationship between meaningful use and certified EHR technology, CEHRT. This education module is created to speak to a broad audience. So while it takes you through some of the specific regulatory requirements published by ONC and CMS, it does not dive deep into a lot of technical details. At the end of this slide deck, I've included hyperlinks to access other CMS and ONC education resources. This slide shows meaningful use measures side by side and the supportive 2014 edition EHR certification criteria. On the left, and inclusive of both stages 1 and 2, there are three measures associated with the transitions of care objective. For stage 1, only the first measure, outlined in red, is required. For stage 2, all three measures, outlined in blue, need to be met by eligible providers. On the right are the two 2014 edition EHR certification criteria adopted to support transitions of care. Regardless of meaningful use stage, eligible providers will need to have and use EHR technology certified to these certification criteria. This training module will use the second of these certification criteria in all of the examples that follow because the meaningful use measures for TOC focus on transmissions from the eligible providers to other parties. The first measure, which was part of the original Stage 1 final rule, can be met through a combination of paper and electronic exchange transmissions. The second measure, which is only required of eligible providers in Stage 2, can only be met through electronic exchange. More specifically, an eligible provider must use their certified EHR technology or an eHealth Exchange participant to successfully transmit a summary care record for more than 10% of transitions of care and referrals. The third measure, which again is only required of eligible providers in Stage 2, can be satisfied in two ways. The first way would be for an eligible provider to electronically transmit a summary care record to a recipient with an EHR technology designed by a different EHR technology vendor than they have as part of meeting Measure 2. The second way would be to conduct an electronic transmission test with a CMS-designated test EHR. CMS will make more information available about this test process prior to the start of Stage 2. Eligible providers who have less than 100 transitions of care and referrals in the reporting period do not have to meet these measures. For any of these measures, it is important to remember that the recipient does not also have to have certified EHR technology. The remainder of this education module will now exclusively focus on MU measure number 2. On the left is measure 2 as quoted from CMS's final rule. As shown with the strike through under paragraph B, the last option provided by this measure is not available because ONC has not yet established a governance mechanism for the Nationwide Health Information Network. Also, as illustrated by the animation, because the NWHIN exchange has changed its name to eHealth Exchange, we have clarified that this change did not affect the policy expressed in the measure. The CMS FAQ listed on the resource slide at the end explains this policy in greater detail. To the right is a slightly more detailed description of the TOC certification criterion adopted at 45 CFR 17314B2. As with all adopted certification criteria, in order for this certification criterion to be satisfied, all specific capabilities expressed under the paragraph number, in this case B2, need to be demonstrated. For 45 CFR 17314B2, there are two specific capabilities. The creation of a summary care record formatted in accordance with the section templates of the consolidated CDA standard with requisite data specified for MU, illustrated by the text box popping up, and enabling a user to electronically transmit a CCDA formatted summary care record in accordance with the following specific transport standards. The Applicability Statement for Secure Health Transport, also known as DIRECT, which is required for all EHR technology to be tested and certified against to meet this certification criterion. Direct plus XDR XDM, which is specified as an optional approach for EHR technology developers. And SOAP plus XDR XDM, which is also specified as an optional approach for EHR technology developers. Both of these latter two options are true options and are not alternatives to the first. For instance, an EHR technology would not meet this certification criterion if it were only tested to the SOAP plus XDR XDM transport standards. Thus, just to state this another way, whatever EHR technology is presented for certification must demonstrate compliance with both paragraphs I and II under B2 to create a CCDA and to be able to transmit it to meet the certification criterion. This also means that there's no transport-only certification as part of 2014 edition certification. Finally, as illustrated by the arrows, paragraph A of measure number 2 is supported by the specific transport capabilities expressed in paragraph II of the certification criterion. Because I'm going to be referencing the numerator and denominator to measure number 2 when I talk later about which transmissions count, I wanted to provide you with this text for your reference. Before we jump into the specifics of measure number 2, I'm going to lay out the available certification options for EHR technology. At the top, as a reminder, is the certification criterion in play, 45 CFR 17314B2. The options I'm about to explain all address the minimum content and transport capabilities required for testing and certification. To be clear, EHR technology cannot be certified to this certification criterion unless one of the following options is pursued. The first valid certification option is what I'll call the native or integrated EHR technology option. In this option, as indicated by the box surrounding provider A, the EHR technology is capable of both CCDA creation and transport. That is to say, the EHR technology performs the functions required of a security and trust agent, or STA, under the direct specification. The second valid option is one where a health information service provider, also known as a HISP, which can be a standalone data intermediary or a component of an HIE entity, gets certified to provide both CCDA creation and transport capabilities in accordance with direct. Under this option, as indicated by the box surrounding the HISP/HIE entity, it would likely be certified as a standalone EHR technology, which ONC's regulation defines as a capital M EHR module. The third option represents instances where one vendor's EHR technology is used to create a CCDA and another's is used to transmit the CCDA in accordance with direct. Under this option, as indicated by the box surrounding both provider A and the HISP/HIE entity, the EHR technology used by provider A would need to be certified together with the HISP/HIE entity's technology in order for the certification criterion to be satisfied. In this instance, a certification is issued to this pairing and only this pairing, meaning that one cannot assert that the EHR technology has met this certification criterion without the specific HISP/HIE entity and vice versa, since both were needed to demonstrate compliance with the certification criterion. Finally, I just wanted to note that while I covered these options for the minimum requirement of direct, one could substitute in SOAP plus XDR XDM or direct plus XDR XDM everywhere I have direct listed to play out the same certification options for those optional transport standards. Now that you have a better understanding of how EHR technology can get certified, let's jump into a more detailed look at all of the approaches eligible providers can take to meet MU measure number 2. Before we walk through the various ways to get the summary care record from provider A to provider B, it is important to remember that the summary care record must reach the provider it is being sent to before it can be counted towards measure number 2. MU approach number 1 involves a few different scenarios for transporting a CCDA with direct or direct plus XDR XDM or SOAP plus XDR XDM. I've broken approach number 1 down into two sub-approaches, 1A and 1B, to help clarify a few details and to separately take on direct and SOAP. Hopefully these three examples look pretty familiar to you now. For approach 1A, these examples all track the certification options I discussed earlier. Each example illustrates the use of CEHRT's capability to perform an electronic transmission in accordance with the required direct transport standard. Thus, eligible providers that electronically transmit summary care records using their CEHRT's direct capability, natively or combined with an intermediary, would be able to count all such electronic transmissions in their numerator, provided that they are received by the recipient. The same scenarios hold for CEHRT that has implemented the optional Direct plus XDR XDM transport standards. Similar to Approach 1A, eligible providers that electronically transmit summary care records using their CEHRT's SOAP plus XDR XDM capability would be able to count all such electronic transmissions in their numerator. Before we move on to approach number 2, I want to call out a few important points for EHR technology developers and eligible providers to keep in mind. First, in order for eligible providers to have the option to use certified EHR technology to perform countable SOAP transmissions, their EHR technology must be certified to the optional SOAP plus XDR XDM transport standards specified in the certification criterion. Second, the fact that there could be a HISP/HIE entity in the middle is irrelevant with respect to Provider A meeting MU requirements. Provider A's use of their CEHRT's optional transport capability enables Provider A to include this transmission in Measure Number 2's numerator, consistent with the measure's requirements and that Provider B receives the summary care record. Third, under this approach, the implication is that HISPs/HIE entities do not need to be separately certified. Thus, if an EHR technology developer wants to offer its customers a HISP/HIE agnostic transport option, seeking certification to the optional SOAP plus XDR XDM transport capability could be advantageous. MU approach number 2 involves the transmission of a CCDA through an eHealth Exchange participant. There are two important points to understand about this approach. First, similar to example 2 in approach 1B, the fact that there is an eHealth Exchange participant in the middle is irrelevant with respect to Provider A meeting MU requirements. Second, an eHealth Exchange participant does not have to be certified. However, Provider A must still use their CEHRT's capability to create the CCDA, and Provider B still needs to receive the summary care record in order for it to count in Provider A's numerator. Up through this point, all of the approaches I've discussed have been push or targeted exchange to a specific recipient. That being said, meaningful use also accommodates and enables quote-unquote pull or quote-unquote query types of exchange architectures to be used and for such exchanges to count in a provider's numerator under certain conditions. Approach 3 addresses these pull or query scenarios. Let's cover a few key points with respect to Approach 3. Similar to Example 2 under Approach 1B, the fact that there is an entity in the middle is irrelevant with respect to providers 1 through 4 meeting MU requirements. However, there are two scenarios to keep in mind when it comes to having EHR technology that meets the certified EHR technology definition and how that could affect MU measurement. Scenario 1. If providers 1 through 4 have CEHRT without the aid of an HIE and use the CEHRT's transport capability, direct or SOAP, to send a CCDA formatted summary care record to an HIE entity, which subsequently enables the summary care record they've sent to be pulled by another provider, then a pull of that summary care record just needs to occur by provider number 5. Scenario 2. In contrast to scenario 1, if providers 1 through 4 depend on the HIE entity to satisfy the CEHRT definition from either a paired or standalone certification approach, and thus rely on it to create the CCDA formatted summary care record and transmit it to provider 5 as a result of a pull, these providers would need to have EHR technology that had been certified in a standalone way or in combination with the HIE to perform the full requirements specified in the certification criterion, as described in prior slides. In either scenario, for all providers where the patient meets the denominator requirements from measure number 2, when provider number 5 pulls the patient's summary care record from the HIE entity, they can count that pull in their numerator as a transmission to provider 5. All right, you've reached the end of this personal pace education module. Let's recap some key points that we've learned along the way. 3 certification options are available for TOC certification. 1. Native capabilities all within the same EHR technology solution. 2. EHR technology plus HIE/HISP combination. 3. HIE/HISP standalone. EHR technology developers that include and seek testing and certification for the optional SOAP plus XDR XDM transport standards can provide a HISP/HIE agnostic solution for their customers. There are three approaches to demonstrating MU. 1A, use EHRT's direct or direct plus XDR XDM capability. 1B, use EHRT's SOAP plus XDR XDM capability. 2, use EHRT to create a CCDA and partner with an eHealth Exchange participant. 3, use EHRT to create a CCDA that is then retrieved/queried by another provider. For any of these MU approaches, transmissions will only count in the measure's numerator if they are received by the provider to whom the sending provider is transitioning or referring the patient. In any approach, the recipient does not also have to have certified EHR technology. Thanks for tuning in to the Meaningful Use Personal PACE Education module on transitions of care. On this slide, you'll find both general EHR incentive programs resources and specific resources associated with transitions of care.